can anyone be saved without baptism? And the answer is yes, it's possible. Faith saves, unbelief condemns. And so a believer like the thief on the cross who dies before or without baptism is what? Saved. Now, here's the point. You cannot be saved if you say you believe in Jesus and you despise baptism and refuse to be baptized. Something is profoundly wrong there. Either the person doesn't really have faith in Jesus, otherwise they would want to be baptized, or they have faith in Jesus, but they are horribly, horribly not properly instructed in the Christian faith. Okay? So the thief on the cross, he died without baptism and was saved because he had faith in Jesus. He didn't despise baptism. He simply didn't have the opportunity to be baptized. But if by God's grace he had survived that crucifixion and 3 months later he was healed up, he would be baptized. Okay? So it's not the absence of baptism necessarily that damns a person. It's the despising of baptism. Okay. The Bible says nothing about the fates of infants who die without baptism. We leave them in God's hands of love, comforting ourselves with the thought that while he himself has bound us to the use of means of grace, he has not bound himself. Needless to say, Christian parents will not unduly postpone the baptism of their children. And here's where I told you the story of my little Mark. Yeah. I baptized him before his surgery. If anything went wrong, I'd have the comfort because I'd be putting all my hope and God's promises, he's told me about baptism, right? And that's where I'd find my comfort if my little Mark had died in surgery or after surgery. This is very important. And we also know children were circumcised at 8 days. Now, there's no rule in the New Testament. There is no rule in the New Testament. It doesn't say. Okay? But basically, in most churches that baptize infants, we don't like to put it off too long. For example, when I went to visit one of our family members who just had a baby, we were talking about infant baptism, and they're looking at the Sunday that they want to get their child baptized. And they told me a sad story. They had some friends who had a baby, and they put the baptism off, put the baptism off, put the baptism off, and then the child died of SIDS, sudden infant death syndrome. Don't plan on that. So generally speaking, there's no rule, but I'd say the average pastor starts getting nervous if we don't have a baptism in about a month. Why are you putting this off? So that's very, very important.